Chennai sir and all the competitive chemistry faculty. A very good morning to all of you. This is Bhavani, belongs to chemistry department. And today my topic is atomic structure. In that atomic structure, I would like to explain about Bohr's postulates and one of the important application of Bohr's postulate is radius of the electron. So we can find the formula for how to calculate the radius between the nucleus and the given particular electron. So what are the Bohr's postulates? Niels Bohr is one of the great scientists. He given some postulates. Those are nothing but Bohr's postulates. According to Bohr's atomic model, he is one of the modified atomic model. In that postulates, the first one is electron revolves around the nucleus in a circular path. The circular path is called a orbit. So if you take an atom, the center point is nucleus. Around this center point, means around this nucleus, electron revolves in a circular path. So the circular path is called orbit. The circular path is called orbit. So see here, these are the circular paths. It is called orbit. These are numbered with 1, 2, 3, 4. So the orbits are represented with the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. These are positive indices. And they are also named with alphabets K, L, M, N like that. And the third one is the angular momentum of the electron is quantized. So angular momentum of the electron is quantized means the formula for this one is MVR is equals to NH by 2 pi. MVR is equals to NH by 2 pi. Where M is mass of the electron and V is velocity of the electron, R is radius of the electron and N should be 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. H is Planck's constant and pi is constant. What is meant by electron angular momentum quantization? So the orbits which satisfy this formula MVR is equals to NH by 2 pi, in that case only electron revolved, otherwise it doesn't revolve. Why? Because for understanding this one, I will tell about one example. If you want to climb a tree or a building, we need one thing, that is nothing but a ladder. So this ladder is associated with some graded horizontal lines. So if we put our foot in that horizontal line only, the climbing is possible. If we put our foot in between the two horizontal lines, definitely we will fall down. So like that, the electrons also, they should means they revolve around the nucleus where the end values are 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. In between the end values, what happens? So in between the end values, they will fall down. So that's why N should be 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. And the next postulate is the energy of the orbit is constant. We know already this is the nucleus. Around the nucleus, electron revolve in a circular path. The circular path is called orbit. So what is the nature of the orbit? Orbit associated with some energy. So the energy of the orbit is constant. What is the nature of the orbit here? The energy of the orbit is constant. So that's why the orbits are called stationary energy levels or stationary energy orbits. So for a particular orbit, the energy of the electron is also constant. It should not vary. It should not vary. When it is varying means, if electron jumps from one orbit to another orbit, in that case only energy transformations takes place. Otherwise, the energy of the orbit is fixed. It is constant. In that orbit, the energy of the electron is also constant. But sometimes what happens, atoms absorb energy. So in that case, electron absorbs energy and it is jumped from lower energy levels to higher energy levels. What is lower energy level? What is higher energy level here? The energy levels which are nearer to nucleus, that is called lower energy level. Which are far away from nucleus, those are called higher energy levels. So electron jumps from lower energy level to higher energy level, than x or less than x. For second orbit, the energy is y electron volts. It is not greater than y or less than y. It should be y. For third orbit, the energy is z electron volts. It is not greater than z or less than z. It should be z. So in this way, the energy of the orbit is fixed. Only electron energy transformation takes place. It jumps from lower to higher or higher to lower. So the change in energy delta E is equals to E2 minus E1, that is equals to h nu. So this is the formula for energy transformations. And the important postulate is the centrifugal force of the electron balanced by the electrostatic attraction forces between the nucleus and electron. See what happens here. For a given atom, the center point is nucleus. Around the nucleus, electron revolve in circular path. So the circular path is called orbit. So here always the nucleus trying to attract the electron towards itself. Towards itself. So for opposing that force, electron also trying to away from the nucleus by applying some force, that is called centrifugal force. Here nucleus attract the electron towards itself, the force is called centripetal force. So against to centripetal force, electron is also opposed, means it also applies some force, that is called centrifugal force. That is called centrifugal force. So both the forces are exactly equal, but they are in opposite direction. Centripetal force means nucleus attraction. Centrifugal force means electron try to away from the nucleus. That is called centrifugal force. Both are equal, but they are in opposite direction. So this is the nucleus. The charge of the nucleus is plus E. This is the electron. Charge of the electron is minus E. And the distance between nucleus to electron is R. The distance between nucleus to electron is R. The centrifugal force of the electron is equals to mv square by R. The centrifugal force of electron is equals to mv square by R. Then how can we derive the formula for centrifugal force? It is completely depends on Coulomb's law. For a given two bodies which contain charges Q1 and Q2, what is the relation between these two means? Some electrostatic attraction forces are acts in between the two bodies. So the electrostatic attraction force is directly proportional to the product of the charges of that bodies, and it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two bodies. So F is directly proportional to Q1 by R square. By removing proportionality, we put a constant, F is equals to K into Q1 by R square. So this is Coulomb's law. By applying this formula, what is the charge of the nucleus? Plus E. What is the charge of the electron? Minus E. So the force is directly proportional to product of the charges. So plus E into minus E. Plus into minus minus E into E square. And it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two bodies, R square. So these two are equal but in opposite direction. That's why we put a negative sign here. So this R is cancelled in R square R times, then we get the formula mv square is equals to E square by R. This is one of the important formula. This is used in formula for radius of electron. How can we calculate the radius of the electron means by using the Bohr's postulate, the third postulate, mvr is equals to nh by 2 pi. So from this formula we get V is equals to nh by 2 pi mr. And V square is equals to n square h square by 4 pi square m square r square. So by simplifying this one, substitute V square value in equation 1. Substitute V square value in equation 1. Then we get finally r value n square h square by 4 pi square m e square. We know the values for the terms. N should be varied. For first shell n is equals to 1, second shell n is equals to 2, third shell n is equals to 3, like that. Where h is equals to Planck's constant, consider the values in CGS units, so then h is equals to 6.625 into 10 to the power of minus 27 meters per second, and mass of the electron is 9.1 × 10⁻²⁸ grams, and charge of the electron in electrostatic units 4.802 × 10⁻¹. So by substituting all these values, we get our value in terms of angstroms 0.529 × n². It is not constant. It is varied for different shells and different electrons based on the given atom. This is for hydrogen atom only. We know already hydrogen atomic number Z is equals to 1 and electronic configuration 1 is 1. Hydrogen contain only 1 electron. Hydrogen contain only 1 electron. So for hydrogen like atoms, how can we apply the formula? Means for hydrogen like species, then the radius is equals to 0.529 × n² by Z. So here atomic number Z is considered in this formula. The units are same angstroms. So in this way we can calculate the radius of the electron in terms of angstroms for different atoms. So this is one of the important formula by using Bohr's postulates. Thank you all.